If you want cheap and affordable games, check out the link below and in the comment section, g2a.com. Get you some cheap games for the holiday, guys. Now onto the video, guys. Listen, it hurts me to say this. It hurts me to say this because I'm a big Gervonta Tank Davis fan. I am, you know. I was a big, you know, I've been watching Davis since way before he became a champion, since he first went on TV. I believe he first went on TV, was it 2015? But yeah, literally since he first fought on live television, like when he first had his first fight on TV. So since he was a teenager, and it hurts me to say this because I'm a fan of him, but the man is running scared of Vasyl Lomachenko. He's running scared. I mean, I even had him as an avatar at one point. At one point, I had Gervonta Davis as an avatar on my original McGregor channel because I was a fan of him. He was one of my favorite fighters at the time. But I don't like how he's blatantly not willing to fight Vasyl Lomachenko. And he's blatantly ignoring him. Like, he sees these tweets. People, if you look at his comment section, whenever he writes a comment or he leaves a post, he gets a bunch of replies, and all of the replies are people talking about Vasyl Lomachenko. So he knows, and telling him about what Vasyl Lomachenko said. So he knows, even if he's not following Vasyl Lomachenko, I'm pretty sure he knows because of Vasyl Lomachenko fans be telling him about this stuff. Sorry about the dogs in the background, by the way. But he doesn't reply to Vasyl Lomachenko ever. He never replies to Vasyl Lomachenko. You know, he goes on Twitter, he replies to Kevin Farmer. I remember he would reply to Kevin Farmer. He would make fun of Kevin Farmer. He was talking about when Kevin Farmer was fighting that Japanese dude, and he lost to him. He was talking about, looks like I'm going to Japan to fight the Japanese guy. He was doing all that, but when Vasyl Lomachenko keeps tweeting about him and talking about him and challenging him and wanting to fight him, there's no reply. But you know what's funny? I think Tank Davis is one of those type of guys that if Vasyl Lomachenko were to lose, then you'll see Tank Davis start tweeting about Vasyl Lomachenko. Then you'll see Tank Davis leaving, you know, tweets saying, oh, I thought he was the pound for pound number one. And, you know, Leonard and LB and all these guys, it's so obvious that they're afraid to put Tank Davis in there with Vasyl Lomachenko, man. It's so obvious, man. Again, if you don't think that Tank Davis doesn't want to challenge himself against Vasyl Lomachenko, then clearly you're either blinded or you're a massive Tank Davis fan or you're a family member of him that you just want to turn a blind eye to that. I mean, you know, I crucified and I made fun of guys like Guillermo Rigondeaux. I think Guillermo Rigondeaux was a quitter. I think Nicholas Walters was a quitter. But at least these guys had the balls to face Vasyl Lomachenko. You know, so if you think about it, these guys who quit, these guys like Guillermo Rigondeaux, who was two weight divisions below him, he wasn't even the same size as him, and who quit against him, and guys like Nicholas Walters and Jason Sosa, all these guys that quit against Vasyl Lomachenko, yeah, they quit, but at least they had the balls to get in the ring with Vasyl Lomachenko, so they actually have bigger balls than Tank Davis has currently. Even Gary Russell Jr., early on in his career, he fought Vasyl Lomachenko. So all these guys are willing to fight Vasyl Lomachenko. That's why I respect him at least more than someone like Tank Davis. But Tank Davis is still not willing to get in the ring and challenge himself against Vasily. And this is why I'm telling you guys. He's never going to fight Vasyl Lomachenko. I believe he's going to move up to 135. I'm not going to say 140. He's too small. Tank Davis is a little guy. He's like 5'6". But probably 135. He'll probably fight someone like... you know what he's going to do instead? He's going to fight the guy who just beat Kevin Farmer at 130. He's going to fight that Japanese dude. He's going to win that belt against that Japanese dude. It's going to be an easy title win for it. No, yeah, I believe it was for the same belt that he vacated. No, that he got stripped because he failed weight, right? He failed weight. So they stripped him of that IBF strap. So when he beats that Japanese guy, he's going to be winning the same belt that he failed that he got stripped from him because he failed weight. And then what? And then he's going to be a champion again. And then he's going to duck Vasyl Lomachenko again. Or maybe he'll fight like that Alberto guy that beat Joel Corrales. Or maybe Miguel Burstead. Or maybe he'll vacate the belts for good and move up to 135. But I never see him actually stepping in the ring with Vasily Lomachenko because he doesn't show no interest in it. His promoter, Flamer the Jr., don't show no interest in it. Both of these guys are afraid of Vasily Lomachenko. They're both afraid of Vasily Lomachenko. They're afraid to lose against Vasily Lomachenko. They're afraid to lose against him. I'm out, guys. Check out G2A and cop yourself some game.